What's up everyone, it's Kenji here, and in this video we're going to create sensitivity tables to see how different price changes affect our business, scenario analysis to see how different forecasts affect our bottom line, and lastly goal seek and solver to see how much we need to sell to reach our financial goals. And to apply these concepts, we'll be using our latest startup idea, a lemonade stand, and you can download the file I'll be working with for free, as I'll leave it in the description below. So let's get into it. Starting off with goal seek, and this formula is useful when you know the result that you want, but you don't really know what inputs to put in it to get that result. For example, maybe we say that for the lemonade stand, we want to make 100,000 in net income, but we don't really know how much we need to sell to reach that number. Let's take a look at the Excel file over here, and we've got the different assumptions on one side and the income statement on the other. And so the assumptions here, we've got the unit sold, so the quantity of lemonade sold, the price for that lemonade, the cost for us to make it. The G&A has to do with general and administrative. So these are usually things like the office rent, the salaries, and other things like that that are fixed in nature. And then we've got the tax rate. And so what we want to reach is the net income figure over here of 100,000. Now to do that, firstly, let's fill in the different income statement lines. So we'll go equals for the revenue, it's just the price times the quantity. So the unit sold times the price per unit. For the COGS, this is going to be the cost of goods sold. So that's equals to the unit sold times, we'll make it a negative here because it's a cost, the cost per unit, press enter. For the gross profit, you can just press the alt equals, that's a shortcut for that, press enter. The reason this over here is a sum is because this one's already a negative, so we don't have to do another minus to it. For the G&A equals negative the G&A here. The earnings before tax is just the equal sum, press the tab key, and we'll select these two here. And then for the taxes, this gets a bit more tricky. That's because if you have negative earnings or if you didn't earn any money, there's obviously nothing for there to be taxed. And so let's put an if statement that's going to give us a condition. So we'll go equals, if, press the tab key. So the logical test is that this figure is going to be less than zero. And if that's the case, if the value if true, then we actually don't want anything. So we're just gonna put a zero there in quotations. Press the comma key again, and the value if false, so if there is an actual profit here, an earnings in this case, what we want to do is tax them, right? So we'll go get this number here and multiply it by that 21%. We actually have to make a negative again, so we'll go do that, press enter. And so in this case, because we do have earnings before tax, we will have a tax rate to that. Then lastly, we'll sum these, equals sum, press the tab key, and select these two. So we've got 988 in net income, and we want to get that to boost all the way to 100,000. One way that we can do that is by changing the quantity sold. So you can either do that manually, say we put 10,000, see what kind of an effect that has, try again with say 50,000, or the other way, the faster, more efficient way to go about it is using goal seek. So for that, firstly, let's put a set of constraints here. And so what we want to put is essentially first merge this so it looks just like this one here. So Alt H M C. And then Control B and then Alt HH, and that's gonna give us the blue border here. Let's go ahead and select that one. I have it under recent, and then we'll do Alt H FC and we'll put a white background, sorry, white color here. And the first constraint is the net income, which we actually want it to be 100,000. Press enter. And now to get to the actual solver, we'll just go to data, what if analysis, and we'll select goal seek. So we want to set this cell here, which is the net income cell, to the value is going to be 100,000. By changing cell, this is the input that we actually want to change, which in our case is the unit sold. So we'll press OK. And now you can see that we've reached 100,000 in net income. Press the OK key here. And that's because we've actually increased the unit sold to over 60,000 here. But that 60,000 in units sold seems like quite a lot of work for us, and we want to try to limit that to say around 25,000, as anything more is probably just not worth it for us. Now the other variable that we could tweak here has to do with the price. Maybe we can increase the price, and so we'll also reach the net income figure faster that way. Now to do so, unfortunately, if we go back to goal seek over here, you'll notice that it only has one specific variable that you can change. So it says to set one cell, it doesn't let you set multiple cells. And that's when something like Solver is going to come handy. Now, as you can see, I have Solver up here, but by default, it's usually not on Excel. So to find it, you can go to File. You can go under Options down here. And then you're going to go to Add-ins. Under Add-ins, you're going to go to Go here. And the one that you want to tick is the Solver Add-in over here. Press OK when you have it. And then it should pop up here. So firstly, let's put the different constraints that we mentioned. Firstly, we want to put that the unit sold is going to have a highest of 25,000, because we said anything above that is really not worth it for us. And let's also put a price here. So a price constraint, basically put something like 9.99, as we don't really think that anyone's going to be willing to buy a lemonade for more than $10, say. So once we have these constraints, we can go up here over to the solver tab. And the set objective, like we mentioned earlier, is just the net income figure. And we want to set this to a value of 100,000. By changing cells, these are the different variables that we want to change. In our case, it's the units sold as well as the price. And then here, subject to the constraints, these are the different constraints that we want to put. So let's go ahead and add. The first constraint is that we want to have the units sold over here to be less than or equals to the 25,000. Press the add. And a second constraint is that we want the price per unit here to be less than or equals to 9.99. Press the add key, and then you can close that. So now we've got the different constraints over here, and you can just press the solve key. Press the OK key here, and now you can see that we've got 25,000 units. We've also got the 100,000 in net income, and we've managed to do this by tweaking the price over here to 8.21 per lemonade. So that's the general idea with GoalSeek and Solver. Next up, we've got the sensitivity analysis or table. And one of the limiting factors with GoalSeek as well as with Solver is that we really only had one final output. So we had one price per unit as well as one quantity sold. But now it'd be nice to have a whole range. So what if the price increased by one? What if it decreased by one? Then what would happen to our net income? So all these things we can do using the sensitivity analysis. For that, go to control page down. And you can find it over here on the table. So this is what we want to fill in. So over here on the left hand side, we have the exact same assumptions that we did previously. Let's go ahead and get started with this. So price per unit is going to be this price over here. Press the control C. Then you can paste it Alt HVV. That's going to just paste the values. So it's not going to change the formatting. And same thing over here. We're going to select it for the unit sold, control C. And we'll paste it over here, Alt HVV. All right, from there, we want to have different ranges. So for the quantity, say by 5,000, so equals this one minus 5,000. Then copy and paste that across. Same thing over here, so 25,000 plus 5,000. And paste that across as well. And for the price per unit, same kind of concept. Let's go up and down $1. So we'll go equals this one minus one. And just paste that across. Same thing on this side, plus one. And there you go. Now, once we have this, we want to dynamically link it. So we're gonna go up to this cell over here, go to equals, and we're gonna select the net income from here, press enter. The reason we want to select it is so that the whole table is now dynamic. From there, we'll go select everything. So control shift down arrow, control shift right arrow. Then we'll go to the data tab under what if analysis again, but this time we'll go for the data table. It's gonna ask us for a row input cell. That's going to be the 25,000 over here, because that's the row. And the column input cell is going to be the 8.21 over here. It's important that you select it from here and not from the table itself, or else it's not gonna work. Press OK, and then that's gonna auto-populate for us. And now we can see that, hey, if we sold at $6 and we sold 15,000, here's how much we'd be making, and all the way across a whole range, right? So it's good to know this. And from there, we can format it a bit better by doing the shift up arrow, shift right arrow here. And usually I like to make it something of a light blue, see? So we'll go to Alt H, and from there we'll select, say, this light blue here. And just for the middle value, which is the current one that we're at from here and here, so we'll go ahead and Alt H, and we'll make that a darker blue, say over here, press enter. And that's a general idea with the sensitivity analysis. It's also quite common to do sensitivity analysis like these ones over here for finance, especially to do with the share price movement and how that might be affected by different growth rates, different discount rates, and other things like that, as you can see over here. Lastly, we've got the scenario analysis, and this is most useful for forecasting. In our case, for example, we're a lemonade stand, we're quite new, so we don't really know what our revenues are going to look like in the future. Same thing with our costs. Will they go up? If so, by how much? All of these are questions that we can solve using scenario analysis. So we'll have three different scenarios, a best case, a base case, and a worst case. So let's go ahead and look at the Excel sheet for that. Over here, down on the bottom, on the gray area, we've got the best case, which is obviously the highest revenues, as well as the lowest costs as well. And first, let's go ahead and format all of this. So the idea is that these are all forecasted years, or they're in the future. Let's go ahead and change that so it reflects it. So select them by pressing the shift right arrow, press the control 1 key, and we're gonna go down to the custom. In here, we want to change this, so we're gonna put something like 4Ys, which are going to stand for the obviously the year keys. And then next up, we're gonna put this inverted dash sign thing, and then press the E, press OK, and that's going to show us the estimate. For these following years, we don't have a number yet, so we'll go equals E date, press the tab key. This is a start date, and we want to essentially add one whole year to that, so it's 12 months, comma 12, press enter, and same thing over here. Once we have this, we actually want to space things out a bit, so control shift, and then control plus key, say do it 3 times. Let's also delete, obviously not delete, but change the font color here to a white, so no fill, alt HH, and from there you'll press the N key, which is going to show you no fill. And the idea here is that we want to have a drop down that's going to tell us, hey, choose a different scenario, and from there you can choose the first scenario, which is the best case, all the way to the worst case. So we'll put choose scenario, and then we can put something like a sign like this, and here we're going to have a 1 for now. Let's go ahead and format this. So we're going to put borders, alt HBA, which is going to stand for all outside borders, and this one we want to say right align, so alt HAR. And now we can get started with this. So for the revenues, we'll go equals. The formula we'll use is the choose formula. Press the tab key, and the index number is going to be the different scenario here. Press the F4 key, that's going to lock it for us. Press the comma key, and the values are going to be, in this case, the revenue scenarios. So this is the first one, comma, the second one over here, and then the third one is this one over here. And we can press enter, and we can just copy that across. And on the cost side, it's the same thing, equals choose, press the tab key, index number is this one, press the F4 key, comma, the values are going to be this time the cost values. First one, second one, and the very last one, press enter, and we'll just drag those across. For the net income, it's just a sum formula, so we'll go alt equals, press enter, and just drag that across. And once we have this, if we change the scenario, say to scenario 3, press enter, this should be changing dynamically. And if we look, say to confirm, 2024 should be a 45,000 negative, and that's exactly the case under the worst case scenario. Let's also delete one row here, we don't really need it, shift space, control minus. One thing you'll notice though, if we change this scenario into something that's not part of the 1 to 3, like say a 5, all of a sudden everything is broken. So let's go ahead and protect this so it can't happen anymore. Press the Ctrl Z to go back there. What we're gonna do is go under the data tab, and we'll go to what's known as data validation, which you can find as this thing over here. Click on it. What we want to put is a list. This is gonna be a drop down list from which people can select the 1, we'll put a comma, 2 and 3, press OK. And now you see that there's a drop down list. In this case, say if somebody comes in and presses a 5, all of a sudden they're not allowed anymore, which is how it should be, right? And just so you get an idea of how this choose formula works, you can actually go ahead under the formulas tab, and you can go to the trace precedence here. That's essentially going to show you where things are linking from. So sometimes it's useful to find. You can put the remove arrows to take that out. Also, sometimes you might find that people like to group these. So for the revenue scenarios, you can press the shift space and then shift down arrow, and you'll do the shift alt and right arrow here, and that's going to group it, so it's essentially going to hide it for you if you say your Excel sheet is too big. For more on Excel, you can check out this link over here, where we teach people about Excel specifically for those looking to break into a business or finance role, or those in it trying to level up their Excel game. Alternatively, you can check out this video over here on financial modeling, or this other video over here on awesome visuals in Excel. Hit that like, hit that subscribe if you liked it, and I'll catch you in the next one.